good afternoon, everyone. We are live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Where in just a matter of moments, we're going to determine who's the tall dog in Class A. And if the first game between these two is any indication, it could be a dandy. As Papillion beat Burke 64-62 in their only other meeting. Papillion ranked number one in the final season ratings, got here by beating Creighton Prep 63-54 and Kearney 44-36. They're 19-4, number one ranked. They were the number two seed in Class A. 20th time at state for the Monarchs. Most recently last year, champs in 26-27. They would like a low scoring game. They average 58 on offense and give up 49. They're coached by a young man that I covered here 16 years ago when he played for Lincoln High. One of the nicest kids then and still a nice person as a young adult. Kevin Albers in his fifth year. For Omaha Burke, the Bulldogs are coached by Gary Greiner. He's been around Burke for a long time, took over for John Jeanette. So these two coaches have been coaching against each other for the last 5 years. That's how long that Greiner's been head coach. The Bulldogs are 17-5. They got here sort of a miracle 90-86 overtime win over Norfolk. And then they battled back to beat Omaha South yesterday 71-66. This is their 14th year in state. Last time here, 88, they were champs in 77-86. They would like a more up-tempo game. They average 72 on offense and give up 62. So it's the Papillion-LaVista Monarchs against the Omaha Burke Bulldogs to determine who's number one in Class A in a year that's seen a ton of teams claim the number one spot over the year. But in the end, it was Papillion-LaVista, and they can cement that number one rating for the state championship here. Let's give you the non-starters for the Omaha Burke Bulldogs. Jared Becker is a 6'5 senior. Jason Yule is a 6' junior. Tyrone Lee, 5'11 junior. Eddie Lund, 6'6 sophomore. Travis Lauritsen, 6'1 senior. Kevin German, 6'3 junior. Scotty Ennis, a 6'3 senior. Perry Newbill, a 6'2 junior. And Adam Jones, a 6'4 sophomore. Here are the starters for the fifth-ranked Bulldogs. Jason Ritchie is a 5'11 senior, 16.5 a game, 3.5 rebounds. He's chipped in 15 in the tournament. Alvin Mitchell is their big gun, 5'11 sophomore, averaged 12 a game and 2.5 rebounds in the regular season, but he's averaging 21 a game here in the state tournament. Matt Brown is a 6'4 senior, 10 points a game and 6 rebounds. He's chipped in 9 in the first two games of the state tournament. And Jeff Hansen is a 6' senior, 7.5 points a game, 3.5 rebounds. He's been very consistent. He's averaged 13 points per game against Norfolk and against South. And Ben Ebong is a 6'5 junior. On the regular season, he averaged 5 a game and 4 rebounds, but he's averaging 15 a game in the tournament. Let's give you the non-starters for the home team, the Monarchs of Papio. James Tyndall is a 5'11 senior. Markwell Munchen is a 5'11 junior. Jason Sokolowicz is a 6'1 senior. Chad Kalen is a 5'11 junior. Kevin Sauerdyke is a 6'3 sophomore. Chris Johnston is a 6'4 senior. And Kevin Munchen is a 6'5 sophomore. Boy, that doesn't roll off the tongue too easy. Munchen, there we go. Here are the Monarch starters. John Ruff, 5'11 senior. 15 a game, 3 rebounds. He's chipped in 26 in the tournament. Ryan Black is a 6'2 senior. 3 points a game, five rebounds. He has 7 points in the tournament. Scott Swanson, a 6'1 senior, 6 points a game, three rebounds on the regular season, 17 points in the tournament. Willie Solomon, a 6 foot junior, 7 points, four rebounds. He has 15 points. And their big gun, David Teixeira. Teixeira, 6'5 senior, 19 a game, 8.5 rebounds. He's got 21 on the tournament. So it's Ruff, Black, Swanson, Solomon, Teixeira. For the Monarchs, the Bulldogs will start Ritchie, Mitchell, Brown, Hanson, and Ebong. Class A has kind of been up for grabs all year long. It'll be trying to remember about how many number one ranked teams we've had all year. At one time, Fremont was undefeated and ranked number one. They really struggled in the second part of the season. Another team that floundered early but came back to play so well was Lincoln East, who made it to the state tournament with an 11-11 record, but really played well late in the season. So here we go, Papillion-LaVista against Omaha Burke. It will be David Teixeira to jump against Ben Ebong. They're both listed at 6'5", but how comes Ebong looks about 2 inches taller? Boy, he's more than 6'5". Usually they oversize people. The ball's in the air, and the tip is controlled by, it's loose and goes out of bounds. Who touched it last? Fighting for it in the backcourt were Black and Swanson. Out of bounds. The ball belongs to the Bulldogs. Here comes Jason Ritchie. Let's see if they'll play here. Both teams going man-to-man. There's a three-point shot, Ritchie. Oh, ho, ho. Jason Ritchie lights it up right off the bat, 3-0. Boy, when the team you're playing hits a three right off the bat, it makes you a little nervous. Scott Swanson, but knowing Kevin Albers' teams, they'll be well-prepared and be patient. There's a shot up. A three-point shot is missed in there by Solomon. Rebound, Burke. Here come the Bulldogs up 3-0. Right down the lane, trying to drop it off was Jeff Hanson. It goes out of bounds, but it was deflected out of bounds by Papio. Every coach hopes his team can hold their composure early in the state tournament. Most of them don't get to play here at the Sports Center. There's the drive by Mitchell. Mitchell misses, and on the block out, Teixeira and Ebong battle, and Teixeira gets called with clearing out with the arm. David Teixeira.
Fouls on David Teixeira, his first personal foul, first team foul against Papillion.
So Coach Kevin Albers would rather have seen things going a little more his way in the first minute of play. Mitchell flips it in to Ebong, and out front it goes to Jason Ritchie. Right down the lane he goes. As he goes, he stumbles. Is it a foul or is he traveled? They're going to call a foul on Papio, and Kevin Albers is all over the official. I believe it's going to be on Solomon.
Foul on Scott Swanson.
Nope, Scott Swanson.
Foul, second team foul against the Monarchs.
Second team foul on Papio. Ritchie, cross-court pass to Jeff Hanson. Hanson comes to the left wing, nothing going. Kicks it back out to Ritchie, off to Alvin Mitchell. Mitchell's been their star scorer. Goes up, tries to drop it off in the middle. It's knocked around, picked up by Ritchie. So right now, Burke getting most of the breaks. On the other end, that's Hanson driving. Hanson shot is up and good.
Jeff Hanson
makes it 5-0. Here come the Monarchs. With the basketball is Ruff. He drops it off for Scott Swanson, and Swanson will bring it out and set it up. Swanson goes to the left wing. Cross-court pass to Ruff. Ruff inside to Teixeira. Teixeira muscles his way in and scores.
David Teixeira
off the lob pass from John Ruff, and it's a 5-2 game. The Bulldogs quickly down court. Hanson gets it off to Ritchie. Back out to Hanson. Cross-court pass is behind Mitchell and out of bounds. Alvin Mitchell got a hand on it, but it went out of bounds. Both teams going man-to-man so far. So Papillion plays it in, down by three. We played 2 minutes of the first quarter. John Ruff Off it goes to Ryan Black. They kick it up top to Swanson. Inside, left-handed bank shot, up and good by Ryan Black. Ryan Black cutting under the basket, got the pass and banked it in with the left hand. On the other end, we've got a charge on Alvin Mitchell, the sophomore, trying to muscle his way to the basketball. Picks up the player control. So across the way, Kevin Albers with all the noise stands up and holds a sign that says Frog. While ago it said Purdue, so certainly they not one pattern to his signs here. 5-4 Burke jumped off to a 5-0 lead. And now you've got a foul on Mitchell. Alvin Mitchell picks up his second foul. Their leading scorer is going to the bench. Alvin Mitchell. So a lot of offense just hit the bench. But I'll tell you, this kid to replace him is a solid player in Travis Lauritsen. Lauritsen, I've seen him play this year before. He's a good, solid six-man off the bench. The Monarchs play it in. Willie Solomon will drop it off for John Ruff. High post it goes to Ryan Black. Off it goes to Swanson. Back out to Ruff. Three-point shot is short, no good. Long rebound comes to Jeff Hansen. He's off and running. On the other end, Richie backs it out to the three-point line and cans it. Man, he just calmly backed up to the three-point line and drilled it. Jason Richie with two threes. 3 minutes into the first quarter, Burke is up 8-4. With the basketball is Willie Solomon. Off it goes to Ruff. Tries to jam a blind pass inside. It's deflected but picked up by Swanson. He gets it out to Solomon. Shot no good. One shot it out. Burke with a rebound. Hansen on the other end. In the lanes. Carry up shot no good. They crash the boards. The putback is up and good by Matt Brown. Right now, Burke owning the boards in the ball game. They're up by 6, 10-4. 4.5 minutes left to go in the first quarter. A very up-tempo Class A game right now. Handling the basketball is Solomon. They get it inside to Teixeira. Teixeira draws the foul, gets the shot up, it doesn't count. David Teixeira, boy, if they can get it to him down low, he's a load. He really knows how to maneuver down low. Travis Lauritsen has his first foul. That's the third team foul. But Teixeira will be at the line. 65% free throw shooter. It's up and no good. Rolled off to the right. Teixeira, 6'5 senior. Second free throw good. And to quote Gary Griner, he said to Teixeira ate us up in the first game. Timeout on the court. 4:20 left to go first quarter. Burke has doubled the score on Papillion. It's Burke 10, Papio 5. Well, it's been a very up-tempo first half of the first quarter. The difference right now basically is Jason Ritchie's two threes. When play resumes, the Burke Bulldogs will play it in the backcourt. Burke 17-5 to this point. And Papillion 19-4. Richie off to Lauritsen. Back out it comes to Hansen. They clear it to Richie on the right wing. All over him is Swanson. To Lauritsen. They'll just work it around. Both teams going man to man. Ebong and Teixeira got a shoving match. In the lane, the shot is up and no good. The shot by Matt Brown was pressured and it came up short. And the air ball chant goes up from the Papillion students. 3:45 in the game now for Papillion is number 54, Kevin Mungin. Mungin in there along with Teixeira to give him a little more height. Solomon on the right wing looking. Inside it goes to Mungin. Out it comes to Ruff. Ruff back to Solomon. They're just playing catch out front. Burke has dropped into what appears to be a 1-3-1 zone. Swanson, they just play catch outside. Papillion very deliberate. The shot, or the pass down low to Swanson. Back out to Teixeira. 17-footer, good. They all, great patience by the Monarchs. They trail by three. Lauritsen on the other end looking. They're looking inside for Ben Ebong, but right now Teixeira has denied him the basketball. Lauritsen down low. Matt Brown almost loses it. Gets it back to Ritchie. Out it comes to Hansen. Hansen, cross-court pass to Lauritsen. Inside Matt Brown's fall away. 10-footer is good. Oh, great fall away jump shot by Matt Brown. Has got Burke back up by five. 2.5 minutes left to go. With the basketball is Solomon. Inside, there is Mungin. Mungin misses once, but puts it back. Mungin, who has 21 points in the tournament, gets his first two. Shot on the other end, short, no good. Running it down is Swanson. Shot was up by Lauritsen, short, and running it down was Scotty Swanson. Three-pointer would tie it here, 12-9. There's Ruff's three-pointer. It's going to be long, no good. They crash the boards. It's out of bounds. Oh, they say Teixeira came over the top and knocked it out of bounds.
In for the Bulldogs, number 51, Jared Becker.
Jared Becker, a big 6'5 senior, checks in. And out goes Ebong. So here come the Bulldogs, leading by three. Ritchie's three-point shot is short, no good. Long rebound, picked off in there by Hansen, but knocked away by Swanson, and Swanson goes diving out of bounds. No, 24, Ruff goes diving out of bounds, trying to save it. Knocked away by Swanson. Ruff almost saved it in front of his own bench. Burke plays it in. Ritchie off to Hansen. Hansen starts his drive, switches his dribble, pulls up. Nothing going. Fall away, 8 foot. Oh, my gosh, what a shot by Jeff Hansen. Looked like he... Great defensive job, but Hansen just hit a terribly difficult shot. Burke back with her five-point lead. Scott Swanson clears it out to Solomon, to Teixeira. Back to Swanson. They're very patient. Papillion, you will not rush them. Mungin. They lob it inside to Teixeira. Teixeira looking. Gets it back out to Ruff. Ruff up top to Mungin. They whip it around the perimeter, and now we've got a foul underneath, and someone's trying to manhandle Teixeira. Papillion. Of course, Kevin Albers came up under Aldi Johnson, who had many times would play very deliberate half-court basketball. That foul is whistled on number 51, Jared Becker. Just the fourth team foul on the Burke Bulldogs. They lead by five with 50 seconds left to go. Out front, Willie Solomon handles the basketball. Off it goes to Ruff. Mungin in the corner. Wide open shot is up and no good by Solomon. We've got, they crash the boards, and it's going to be a foul on Papio. So Burke with a five-point lead. Mungin picks up his first foul.
In for Omaha Burke, number 45, Scotty Ennis.
Scotty Ennis checks in for the Bulldogs, and out goes number 35, Matt Brown. Burke by five. They have the basketball and probably will try and hold it for the first shot. Gary Grainer hollering out instructions to Jason Ritchie. They just hold it out front. As long as no one comes out and makes an effort to guard you, you can just stand out there. 15 seconds as the boring chant goes up. Burke will lead. There's a three-point shot by Ritchie. Oh, around the ring, no good. Rebound comes down, long up-court pass, driving for the basket, and it's up and no good. Oh! Scott Swanson had the breakaway, and instead of using the glass, he went straight for the basket. And that's kind of a no-no, and Scotty found out why. We've played one quarter in the Class A 1993 state championship game. It's Burke 14, Papillion-LaVista 9. Well, I'm sure in many ways neither coach overly happy with that first quarter, but I think Kevin Albers would have settled for that final basket by Scott Swanson. That would have cut the margin to three, but they can't play it over. The reason being, you'll get the ball here, and a three would have tied it. The Monarchs play it in. Ruff handles the basketball to Swanson. Swanson. They just play it around the perimeter. Papillion, very deliberate. Teixeira, 18-foot shot. Good. Right on the line. Close to 19. Teixeira has 7 of their 9 points, or 7 of their 10 points. 11 points. Now they put it up. 14-11. Inside it goes. Working is Ennis. Back out it comes. Hansen trying to penetrate. Throws it away. Jeff Hansen trying to get it down low to Becker, and a little high and wide and out of bounds. So now a three-pointer would tie it up. But Papillion's not a big three-point shooting team. Swanson on the other end. They work it around the perimeter as Solomon gets it off the rough. Down low to Swanson. Batted away, but he gets it back. Lobs it out, and it's deflected away. Here comes Ritchie on the breakaway. Lead. Oh! Foul. Great defensive play by Willie Solomon. On the breakaway, Kevin Albers wants to talk to the official.
Fouls on Willie Solomon, his first personal foul.
Solomon will send Lauritzen to the line.
Number 31, Alvin Mitchell.
Alvin Mitchell is back in for Burke.
At the free throw line,
Mitchell, their leading scorer in the tournament,
Travis Lauritzen, shooting two shots.
Got in early foul trouble. Travis Lauritzen at the line, and it's good.
And for the Monarchs, number 50, Chris Johnston. One shot.
Chris Johnston in. And out comes Swanson. Lauritzen still has one free throw left. And you can count it. Burke has got their five-point lead back that they had at the end of the first quarter. Papillion-LaVista has really been swimming upstream so far in this first half. Inside it goes. The shot is up and no good. But the reason being, traveling. Ryan Black trying to muscle his way to the basket. For a moment you thought it was a foul because there was a collision, but they said he traveled before all the bodies started to fly. 6:40 left to go in the first half. Jason Ritchie, the Bulldogs' leading scorer, gets it back out to Lauritzen, off to Mitchell. Inside it goes to Scotty Ennis. Short jump shot is good. Scotty Ennis, a 6'3 senior, gets his first two, and Burke extends their lead to 7. Rough with the basketball. It would appear that Papillion, this is the first time I've seen them, doesn't have quite as many offensive weapons as Burke. There's a shot out of the corner, wide open is Solomon, and cans it. Willie Solomon gets it down. On the other end, Alvin Mitchell answers. 20-13, still the 7-point lead. 5:45 left to go. Inside they get it. Downloaded to Teixeira. Teixeira at the baseline, no advantage. Off to Solomon. Solomon, out it comes to Ruff. Ruff penetrates, has the ball knocked loose, and it's picked up on the court by Lauritzen. Down court is Ritchie, and it's stripped away. And is it a foul? Yes, they're going to call a foul on Johnston. So Burke's got the ball bouncing their way. Right now they're just outplaying Papillion-LaVista. And for Papillion,
number 30, Chad Kalaw, and number 54, Kevin
Kalaw.
At the free throw line for Omaha Burke, number 23, Jason Ritchie.
And number 54, Mungin, back in for Papillion. Two shots coming for Ritchie. Up and no good. Jason is a 68% free throw shooter. He averaged 16 and a half a game on the regular season. Burke by 7. Here's the second attempt, and it's good. Of course, yesterday, South led the whole first half, and Burke ran him down in the second half. The way things were going, that's what Kevin Albers and the Papillion-LaVista Monarchs are going to have to do here today. With the basketball, Johnston inside to Teixeira. Back out to Johnston. Inside it goes to Mungin. Teixeira. They just play catch on the left side. with the basketball is Kalaw. Bounce pass off to Solomon. Against this zone, they're just going to tell Papillion, if you can shoot it out of shoot us out of the zone, fine. Skip pass up to the top to Kalaw. Off it goes to Solomon. Back out, fakes the three. Gets it off to Johnston. Back out, Kalaw. Nothing going. And there's a bounce pass stolen away by Lauritsen. Throws it out to Hansen. Hansen on the run. Hansen puts it up. It's no good. It was blocked on the way in. No foul. As Hansen hits the deck, and Gary Grainer is up screaming at the officials. In the front court comes Kalaw. Chad Kalaw. There's a shot up, and is it two? 2 points by Willie Solomon, who has four. 6 point lead on the other end. Alvin Mitchell shot up, no good. And the rebound is knocked out of bounds, but a foul's going to be called as Scotty Ennis goes over the back. Just a 15 foul on Burke. Ebong and Matt Brown getting set to check back in for Burke. So Papio's got the lead down to six, and we've got timeout. 4:21 left to go in the first half. Burke 21, Papio 15. Well, Papillion-LaVista has been trying to climb this mountain the whole first half. They're down by six, and we're halfway through the second quarter. You got a very patient, deliberate team against a team that would like to get it out and get it down the court. Kalaw. Off it goes to Ruff, who's now in there. Inside to Teixeira. Teixeira. Skip pass to Solomon. Willie Solomon gets it out to Kalaw. Kalaw back to Solomon. Against this tough zone defense, Burke very quick. You've got to really move the ball well and be patient. Kalaw, off it comes to Ruff. Ruff's three-point shot. Count it. John Ruff gets his first basket, and it's three. 21-18. That's what they wanted to do, was get Ruff off the point and get him on a wing. Inside, Ben Ebong. Is he fouled in there or tied up? Ooh, foul on Ruff. They've been trying to get it into Ebong, and he's been frustrated, and finally they did, and Ruff fouls him. Still not in the one and one. Burke 21, Papillion 18. 3:36 left to go as Richie checks back in for the Bulldogs. Alvin Mitchell right into the basket. Brown shot is blocked. Brown shot is blocked, and Teixeira comes up with it. It may have been Munger that blocked that. Papio can tie it with a three. Off it goes to Solomon. Back to Kalaw. Kalaw takes the 18-footer. It's good. He faked it. They backed off. And then Kalaw cans it. 21-20, Burke. Alvin Mitchell to Richie. Off it goes to Hansen. Hansen goes to the baseline. Offensive foul. It's going to be a charge on Jeff Hansen, and the pendulum has swung.
Offensive foul on Jeff Hansen, his first personal foul.
Hansen picks up his first, but that's the sixth. And so both teams will head into the one and one. Swanson checks in, and out goes Kalaw. And Kalaw gets a nice hand. His last basket brought them within one. So Burke, who's been chasing him all the time, may finally catch them. They've not led. Here comes Solomon across the timeline. Still going, and he's fouled in there by Matt Brown. Brown threw an elbow or threw a shoulder into him as Solomon dribbled by him. And so Willie Solomon will go to the line.
Fouls on Matt Brown, his first personal foul, 17 fouls.
So Papio with a chance to have their first lead. They were down by as much as eight.
At the free throw line for Papillion-LaVista, number 42, Willie Solomon. He'll be shooting 1-1.
At the line will be Willie Solomon, a 60% free throw shooter. It's good. 5 points for Willie Solomon. We're tied at 21. Well, we just had a dandy, a 3-second shot at the buzzer, giving Elgin a 1-point win over Hyannis. Second free throw, climbs over the front of the ring, and it's good. Solomon with 6 points, all here in the second quarter. Timeout on the floor. 2:54 remaining in the first half. The Papillion-LaVista students and fans getting into this. It's now Papio 22, Burke 21. Well, I mentioned how I've known Papillion-LaVista coach Kevin Albers ever since he played for Lincoln High 16, 17 years ago. They had a great shot of Kevin when he played in the 67 state tournament, flying into the crowd trying to retrieve a ball that went out of bounds. One of those classic pictures that they get of someone flying over, I think it was a scorer's table, trying to get a loose ball. He's always been one of my favorites. After doing sports in this town for over 20 years, you get some favorites, and he's one of them. Papio with the lead. Burke with the basketball. And now we've got a foul underneath as Scott Swanson is holding on Richie, who's trying to work free. Jason Richie, their leading scorer, got rid of the basketball, then tried to circle down low, and Scott Swanson gets called for the foul. Second foul on Swanson. Jason Richie back at the free throw line where he's 1 out of 2. Close to a 70% free throw shooter. Richie hit those two big threes to get the game started. It's up and good. So we're tied at 22. Burke had a 5-point first quarter lead. That's been evened up by Papio. Second free throw, and it's good. 9 points for Richie. Backcourt pressure. Willie Solomon dribbles through traffic, gets it across the timeline. Nice job of Willie Solomon, but getting it across the line. Off to Teixeira, and they get it off to John Ruff. John Ruff, that pass down low. Swanson gets it in. Oh, what a bullet pass from Ruff. He'll get the assist, and Scott Swanson gets his first basket. Papillion back out in front, 25-23. On the other end, Mitchell drives, goes up with a shot, and Ruff strips it away from him. Ruff strips it away, and picking it up was Mungin. Off to Teixeira. Teixeira brings it across the timeline. Gets it off to Ruff. Papillion, a real blue-collar team. Ruff has it knocked away, gets it back. Teixeira sets up for three. Bingo! David Teixeira! Papio, what a swing around. They've outscored Burke by 9 in the second quarter. A minute 49 left to go. Mitchell handles. Off to Richie. In the corner, there's the shot by Mitchell. It's no good. Rebound, Ebong. Put back good. Ben Ebong has his first two as he rebounds on the weak side and gets the put back. Burke back within two. A minute and a half left to go. Ruff across the timeline. Good physical, hard-fought basketball game. Pass underneath, and Ruff throws it away. And Kevin Albers gets up and hollers something at Ruff. Ryan Black returns for Papio. And 33, Lauritsen checks in along with Becker. It's two new faces in for Burke. Here they come with a chance to tie or go ahead. They trail by two. Lauritsen handles the basketball. Brings it up top, drops it off for Richie. Ruff is all over him. Richie in the lane, pulls up, and they were in his face. He tried to drop it off, but he loses it on the turnover to Papio. Solomon gets it across the timeline to Ruff. Ruff is going to be trapped, skips it over the top to Solomon. Solomon in the corner to a Black, who's now in there. Back up over the top to Ruff. There's the three-point shot by Solomon. It's going to be short, and they battle for the rebound, and Solomon's going to pick up the foul. Willie Solomon, after he missed, followed a little too aggressively.
Fouls on Willie Solomon, his second personal foul.
So headed to the line with 46 seconds left to go in the first half and a chance to tie it will be Jeff Hansen. Hansen is a 65% free throw shooter.
Chad Kalaw
is in, and out goes Willie Solomon. Hansen has 4 points all in the first quarter. This has been an interesting basketball game. Free throws up and good. As we say, their first one was a dandy. Papillion-LaVista winning that one 64-62. Here comes the free throw that would tie it up. Hanson's got it up and down. 6 points for Hanson. Now Burke will drop back as Papillion-LaVista will probably try for the last shot. Across the timeline comes Kalaw. Gets it off to Ruff. Ruff. A pass almost knocked out of bounds, but Ruff saves it. Now his pass is intercepted. Trying to pass it through the quick hands of Omaha Burke. Now Burke will get the last shot. So you got to think Kevin Albers won't be too unhappy with his second quarter, even if he trails, because his kids were down by five and they may have battled back to tie it. Lauritsen, 7 seconds back in the corner. Richie drives. Richie comes out from under the basket. Oh, my gosh! What a reverse spin move by Jason Richie. Man, he hung up there forever. Then instead of banking it off the glass, he just flipped it up in the air. It caught the side of the ring, had so much spin on it that it spun it right into the basket. Unbelievable reverse shot by Jason Richie gives Omaha Burke the halftime lead. At halftime, it's Burke 29, Papillion-LaVista 27. Well, we are in the process of trying to determine the 1993 Class A state championship team. And at halftime, it's Burke 29, Papillion 27. Leading all scorers unofficially, Jason Richie with 11. Also for Burke, 6 for Jeff Hanson, 4 for Brown, and 2 each for Alvin Mitchell, Van Ebong, Lauritsen, and Ennis. So there are 2 big guns in the tournament. Alvin Mitchell and Ben Ebong have just 4 points between them in this first half.
A final on the Big Eight tournament.
Over on the Papillion-LaVista side,
Kansas 67.
Teixeira 10, 6 for Solomon, 3 for Ruff, and 2 each for Black, Swanson, Kalaw, and Munchen. So it's been a dandy first half. The score probably more to the liking of Papillion. They basically would like a fairly low-scoring game. If it gets in the 70s and 80s, that may be a little too much. Burke plays it in, leading by 2. Their 2 leading scorers, Richie and Mitchell, handle the ball to begin with. Mitchell penetrates, 13-footer, won't go. Haida grabbed the rebound, is Munchen. Munchen, outlet pass to Ruff. Ruff gets it across the timeline. Ruff into the corner. It goes to Swanson. Swanson with his Pete Rose crew cut has the ball knocked away off of him and out of bounds. Swanson got stripped by Richie and then it went off of Swanson and out of bounds. Here comes Burke leading by 2. They were state champions in 77 and 86. Mitchell's 3-pointer counted. Alvin Mitchell starts the second half just as Richie started the first half, and that's with a 3. So immediately, Papio falls down by 5. They've been trying to climb back up this hill the entire game. There's Ruff from 17. It won't go. Haida grabbed the rebound. Jason Richie. Outlet pass to Hanson. Here come the Bulldogs. Hanson has the ball knocked away in the lane by Munchen. It's out to Mitchell. 3-pointer good. Holy moly. Alvin Mitchell, who got in foul trouble early and had only 2 points in the second half, must have heard me say that he and Ebong were well below their scoring averages. All of a sudden, it's an 8-point lead. Solomon out to Swanson. Papillion doesn't get rattled very easily. Down low it goes Munchen. Turn around, 5-footer good. Nice hang time for Kevin Munchen. Munchen's got Papio back within 6. Inside it goes Matt Brown. Brown's 10-footer won't go. They crash the boards, and it's saved by Brown. Kept alive in there by Ebong, and Brown ran it down. Richie between the foot dribble. Scoop shot, no good. Tip shot, no good. Ebong over the back. That ball was tipped up there, I believe, by Brown. It didn't go down, and now up and limping badly is Ritchie. Jason Ritchie comes up limping. As he got knocked to the floor. Ebong's first personal foul, but the story on that may have been Ritchie got banged up a little bit. 6 minutes left in the third quarter and a 6-point lead for Burke. With the basketball is Teixeira. Off it goes to Swanson. Inside they get it. And there's a shot by Teixeira, blocked out of bounds by Ebong. And now Ebong gets in his face. Ben Ebong blocked that out of bounds and then exchanged a few words with Teixeira. Ritchie comes limping out rather badly. Replaced in there. Let's see who comes in. Lauritsen. The Monarchs handle the basketball. Down by six, but it takes a lot to rattle them. Solomon, skip pass over the top to Swanson. Swanson back out to Ruff. Off to Solomon. Inside to Munchen. 3-point shot. Solomon, it's going to be way too long. Rebound. Oh, almost stolen away by Swanson. He almost stripped Matt Brown. 35-29. Burke leads with 5:26 remaining third quarter. We already have champions in Sterling and a miracle finish by the Elgin Eagles. 3-point shot, Mitchell, short off the front of the ring. Rebound, Matt Brown. Brown goes up, has it knocked away by Ruff. Getting it back is Ebong. His shot no good. Tip shot no good. They battle. Hansen comes up with it. Burke out muscling Papio right now. Then they throw it away. Hansen, after they out muscled Papio three times, throws it away. Inside it goes to Munchen. Back to Swanson. Inside to Munchen. Swanson from outside. Shot is up and good. It's a two. Swanson hits it. Papio back within four. Mitchell drives. In the corner, wide open is Hansen, three.
Three-pointer for Jim Hansen.
All three baskets for the Bulldogs have been trays. In the third quarter, 7-point lead. Ruff pulls up, 15-footer, won't go. They battle for the rebound. Lauritsen outduels Swanson. Up court it comes to Mitchell. Mitchell drives, running jump shot. It won't go. Rebound is knocked out of bounds by Papio. And has happened in the first quarter. Burke is out hustling Papio right now and out rebounding him. Timeout on the floor. 4:10 remaining in this third quarter. Burke 38, Papillion-LaVista 31. Well, this is the first quarter all over again. When Burke out muscled and out hustled Papio, and then Papio slowly but surely fought their way back in it. Let's see what happens here in the final half of the third quarter. Lauritsen flips it out to Hansen. Hansen up top, comes right side to Mitchell. Jason Ritchie is still out of there. He got banged up when he crashed to the floor earlier and went out limping badly. Hansen to Mitchell. Mitchell trying to work against Solomon. Goes left corner. Kicks it out to Lauritsen. Burke being very patient right now. Hansen drives for the basket. Short bank shot is up and good. Nice hang time for Jeff Hansen. That's the first 2-point basket of the third quarter. And Burke has their biggest lead at 9. Solomon back to Ruff. John Ruff, who pretty much runs the show. They get it in the corner. Solomon 3-point shot. It won't go. And Ebong out battles Ryan Black. Ben Ebong flexing his muscles inside off the boards. Now it's getting to be a bit of concern for Kevin Albers and his coaching crew. On the other end, they drop it off for Ebong. Shot in the paint. It's good.
Ben Ebong
answers on both ends with a rebound and a basket. An 11-point lead for Burke. They led by two at halftime. They've outscored them 13-4. Teixeira. David had 10 points in the first half. He's been held scoreless so far in the third quarter. 2:40 left to go. Solomon, as they try and set up a different offense against this defense. Ruff's 3-point shot is in and out, no good. Boy, Papio can't buy a basket. Rebound, Swanson. Off to Solomon. Solomon being two-time and gets it out to Teixeira. 2:20 left to go. Inside they get it to Black. Black, no shot. Loops it back out to Solomon. Off to Teixeira. Boy, Papio needs a basket desperately right now. Inside, muscling his way to the basket. And foul, or knocked out of bounds. Ryan Black trying to muscle his way to the basket. Had the ball ripped out of his hands and out of bounds by Ben Ebong. 2:07 left to go in the third quarter as Kalaw checks in and Swanson goes out for Papio. Kevin Albers knows this is a very crucial time. His team is down further than he wants them to be, but there's still plenty of time left if they can hold their own here and pick up a little ground. They're down by 11. They've just scored 4 points in this third quarter against the zone. There's Teixeira. Teixeira's shot won't go. Tip shot won't go. Rebound, Solomon. So Papio gets a break. Three-point shot by Ruff. It comes up short. They can't get it. Ruff gets the rebound. The putback is no good, but he's fouled in there. Papio can't buy a basket right now from any range. Becker picks up the foul.
Fouls on Jared Becker, his second personal foul.
So let's see if they can get some points from the free throw line. Burke has outscored him by 9 points here in the third quarter. Rough to shoot two, 63% free throw shooter. It's good. 10-point lead for Burke. Make it nine. A minute 45 left to go in a 9-point lead. And Burke would like to cut into this a little bit more. They can't fall too far behind this good shooting team. Ebong in the middle, misses. Rebound comes off to Solomon. Willie Solomon grabs the rebound. And he drops it off now for Kalaw. Kalaw. Looking. Gets it off to Ryan Black. Off it goes to Solomon. Inside to Teixeira. Teixeira's fadeaway 12-footer. Good. David Teixeira on the fall away. Gets it down. His first two of the second half. Papio back within seven. This is exactly what they did, but they didn't trail quite this far in the first quarter. Cross-court pass. Lauritsen's open. It's going to be off the mark. Rebound. Oh, great rebound by Ryan Black. Black was caught in between two Burke defenders and somehow got off the floor and grabbed the rebound. Papillion with the basketball. They've been behind almost the entire game. Inside it goes to Black. In the corner to Teixeira. They're trying to move the ball around. Kalaw gets it off to Solomon. Back to Kalaw. 3-point shot. It is good. 3-pointer by Kalaw, who's hit two baskets, and both of them have been big. Papio back within four. They were down by 11 just moments ago. 10 seconds left to go. Here comes Alvin Mitchell. Alvin Mitchell, bounce pass Lauritsen. 3-point shot is going to be off the mark. And a rebound. They're not going to get a shot off. It would have been close. It would have been close, but no cigar. So the third quarter mirrors the first quarter, where Burke gets a lead and Papillion battles back. After three quarters, from the Bob Devaney Sports Center, Omaha Burke 42, Papillion-LaVista 38. Well, the big story for Burke is that their leading scorer, Jason Ritchie, is still out of the game with an injury. Burke added two more points to their halftime lead. They lead by four. Papillion will play it in. They get it in to Swanson. Off it goes to Solomon. Solomon across the timeline. Burke will now go man-to-man. Let's see if they can find Teixeira. Off it goes to Swanson. Out to Black. To Ruff. Ruff. Swanson, they work around the perimeter, and now we got a foul inside. Becker trying to out-muscle Teixeira. Third foul on Jared Becker.
Fouls on Jared Becker. His third personal foul.
So both teams a long ways. Burke's committed three fouls in the second half, Papio none. So we may not go to the line for 1-1 in this fourth quarter. Papillion down by four. Black and Ruff just play catch. Papio trying to determine if they're in a man-to-man or in that zone. Fadeaway jump shot, good by David Teixeira. Teixeira gets Papio back within two. 42-40. Boy, this half is looking just like the other one. Scotty Ennis puts up a shot, and it's good. That's just exactly what Scotty Ennis did when he came in the second quarter. These two quarters are so much alike, it's unbelievable. 6:55 left to go. Dandy ball game. Swanson off to Solomon. Ryan Black inside. Low Scotty. Oh, great save by Scott Swanson. Swanson went flying out of bounds and bounced it off Jared Becker. Jason Ritchie comes hobbling back in.
And for the Monarchs, number 54, Kevin Munchen.
Munchen comes in and Black goes out.
Ladies and gentlemen, please refrain from throwing ice or any type of debris onto the playing floor.
Papillion gets ready to play it in. They get it into Teixeira. Now out to Ruff, back to Teixeira. Burke's gone back into a zone after starting out in man-to-man. Ruff penetrates, kicks it off to Solomon. Solomon inside to Munchen. They work it around, three-point shot by Solomon. Oh, it won't go. Running down the rebound is the hobbled Jason Ritchie. Up court it comes Mitchell. Mitchell pulls up, 12-footer, won't go. Rebound, Solomon. Willie Solomon's really been a tiger on the boards. Papillion still trying to climb the hill, though. Three-point shot by Ruff. It won't go. Tip shot by Munchen won't go. And now Munchen is fouled inside. Kevin Munchen is rapidly becoming a factor.
They can seriously injure a player while the play is in progress.
The foul was the third. Oh, wait a second. Let's see who they whistle that on.
It's on Scotty Ennis, his second personal foul.
Ennis picks up the foul. And Kevin Munchen, a 6'5 sophomore. At the line. Puts it up, and it's good. Boy, this kid looks like a promising sophomore. Trouble is, there's four seniors in their starting lineup. They're pretty heavily laden. Ebong is out. And Matt Brown is in. Also coming in is number 25. No, that's Ebong is back in. Okay, along with Matt Brown. Munchen can get them back within two. It's up. Count it. 44-42, and even 6 minutes left to go in this game. Papillion-LaVista has been trying to catch Burke all day. They did briefly. Then Burke opened up an 11-point lead. Out it comes, three-point shot. Lauritsen's going to be way too long. Rebound run down by Solomon, and he bounces it off of Ebong and out of bounds. Willie Solomon has been unbelievable in this game. He only has 6 points, but he has been unbelievable in working his way in for rebounds. What a nose the kid has got for the basketball. Timeout on the court with 5:45 remaining in this game. It is a dandy. Burke 44, Papio 42. It will be Papillion's basketball after a sensational play by Willie Solomon. Let's see if Papillion can catch him here or not. Ruff looking, gets it into Swanson. Swanson dribbling in the backcourt. Off it goes to Teixeira. Teixeira, up court it comes to Swanson. Behind the back dribble, oh, great play by Swanson. On the other end, Ruff, it's up and it's no good. Rebound, Teixeira, put back his good and he's fouled! David Teixeira gave Ebong the head and shoulders break. He took it. He tried to foul him so he couldn't make the basket and missed. David Teixeira. Boy, what a composed group this Papillion-LaVista ball club is. Hanson back in for Burke. And I say that because they've had to battle back all day. Burke has led most of the way. For Ebong, that was his second foul. Teixeira can give them the lead here. And he does. 17 points for Teixeira. A lot of time left, but Papillion has finally caught Burke at 45-44. This is what Burke did to Omaha South yesterday. They trailed most of the first half and then stuck it to him in the second half. Shot by Mitchell, no good. Munchin with the rebound. The 6'5 sophomore has really been a factor since entering the lineup. Munchin with another rebound. He's also got 6 key points. Papio with the basketball. Now they're playing their style of basketball, make the other team come to them. Ruff splits two defenders. Down low, oh, too hard a pass for Munchin to handle. Penetration by Ruff, then he tried to dump it off for Munchin, but it was too hard. Ruff had the right idea, just threw it too hard for Munchin, or it would have been an easy two. Here comes the Burke Bulldogs trying to recapture the lead here. With the basketball is Jason Ritchie, who got banged up, seems to be moving a little bit better right now. Mitchell, off it goes. Oh, we've got a, what do we got? Swanson trying to fight through a pick. Really, that may have been a wise foul, or a good foul, I should say, because Ritchie was wide open to shoot the three. That's only the first foul of the second half against Papillion-LaVista. That may have turned out to be a break for Papio. Although we don't know how well Ritchie can shoot it with that bad leg. They lob it into Becker. Now out to Ritchie. There's Mitchell. Mitchell with Solomon right in his face. Kicks it back out to Ritchie. Swanson's got him. A one-point lead for Papillion-LaVista. High post to Becker. Becker drives. Gets it off to Ritchie. Ritchie drives in the paint. Out to Mitchell. Three-pointer. Count it. Three baskets and all are threes for Mitchell in the second half. Burke back up by two. We're not quite halfway through the fourth quarter. Solomon, off it goes. No, it was Teixeira off to Solomon. Back to Teixeira. Out it comes to Ruff. Two-point lead for Burke. Swanson out to Solomon, off to Ruff. Three-point shot, good! Ruff has two baskets, both are threes. On the other end, shot is up and missed, but Mitchell puts it back for two. Alvin Mitchell follows his own missed shot, and Burke goes out in front 49-48. 3:25 left to go. Ruff looking for someone to pass to. Off to Teixeira. Teixeira looking. Gets it back to John Ruff. They're looking inside for Munchin. Ruff. Off it goes to Swanson. Swanson, inside to Munchin. Munchin, eight-footer, no, oh, won't go. Rebound, Solomon, put back, good, Willie Solomon. Holy cow, what a game this kid has played. 50-49, 2:50 left to go. We've gone back and forth and back and forth. Burke with the basketball, down by one. Alvin Mitchell getting the pick, heads for the basket, and is fouled on the way in. And this is okay, and I'll tell you why. That's only the second team foul, and Mitchell was going to go by him. And I think Papillion-LaVista is well aware of the foul situation. Third foul on Solomon. And now we've got timeout. What a dandy this is. 2:43 remaining. The score, Papillion-LaVista 50, Omaha Burke 49. Well, this is one where some kind of break probably is going to win the game. Burke to inbounds, trailing by one. Alvin Mitchell looking, lobs it into Ebong. Out it comes to Ritchie. Ritchie down the lane, bum, knee and all, and he's fouled on the way in. Jason Ritchie penetrated and was fouled on the way in, I believe, by Black. Oh, the foul is on Ruff. But they said it was while Ritchie was in the act. And so Jason Ritchie, who's 3 out of 4 from the free throw line and a 68% free throw shooter, can put his Bulldogs back out in front. It's up, and it's good. First point of the second half for Jason Ritchie, but it couldn't have come at a more opportune time. He's got him tied at 50. Here's the second attempt. It's too strong. Rebound, battle for. They crash the boards, and we've got a foul. We've got a foul. It's going to be against Burke. Ritchie's second free throw was too strong. Now, they're still not in the one-and-one. Fourth foul on Becker. But it's a key foul in that it will put Papio in the one-and-one from here on out. Only 3 team fouls so far against Papillion-LaVista. We're tied at 50. 2.5 minutes left to go. What a fitting end to the Class A season, which has had a lot of very even teams. Ruff. Off it goes to Solomon. To Teixeira. Teixeira. Out front it comes to Ruff. Ruff penetrates. Nothing going. Swanson turns down the shot. Three-pointer by Ruff. It's going to be too long, but Swanson rebounds. Back to Ruff. To Swanson. Cross-court pass to Teixeira. Nothing going. Down to 1:58. We're tied. Three-point shot by Ruff. It's going to be short. That's what happens when you're tired. There's Hanson on the breakaway. Oh, what a steal. Now, Swanson, an unbelievable deflection by Swanson, picked up by Ryan Black. Oh, my gosh. Swanson dove, hit the floor, knocked it away, and his teammate Ryan Black ran it down. That may be the play of the game. If Papio can cash in. And now Kevin Albers wants timeout. Holy cow. What a round of applause and appreciation for one great effort by Scott Swanson. It looked like a sure breakaway for Burke, but Swanson not only knocked it loose, but allowed his teammate Ryan Black to run it down. Timeout. 1:27 remaining in this Class A championship game. We're tied at 50. I'll tell you who's Scott Swanson. It finally dawned on me who he reminds me of with that crew cut, and that's ex-Cardinal manager Whitey Herzog. And I want to tell you, he's about as competitive. Man, what a play by Swanson. Now let's see if Papillion-LaVista cashes in and wins the game off of that tremendous defensive play by Swanson. Papillion-LaVista will play it in.
Thank you.
Ruff will play it in right in front of the Burke fans. Here it goes. It comes into Willie Solomon. 1:25 left to go. Solomon dribbles free. And now he'll kick it out to John Ruff. Down to 1:15. Let's see if they try and run it all the way down, or if they'll take the break if they can get it. Mitchell knocks it away from Ruff, but John gets it back. Off to Solomon. Of course, Papillion-LaVista's in the 1-and-1 if they get fouled. Swanson off to Solomon. Solomon out to Mungin. Off it goes to Ruff. In the corner to Swanson. Back out to Solomon. Down to 52 seconds. There's a three-point shot by Ruff. It won't go. And a foul. But it won't put them in the 1-and-1. Foul is on Solomon. John Ruff pulled the trigger. It was too long. And this is the benefit of not having committed a lot of fouls early in this half. That's only the 4th team foul. But what it gives is Burke the basketball with 47.8 seconds left. We're tied at 50. So now the wheels start to turn between Gary Grainer and Kevin Albers. Here come the Burke Bulldogs. Will they be able to hang on to it for that final shot? Burke with that miracle finish and then beating Norfolk in overtime. Are they destined to do it again? Ritchie looks at the clock. 23 seconds left to go. Swanson's out on him. Out comes Hanson. Who will take the final shot? And now Gary Grainer wants timeout. Timeout Burke. 16.2 seconds left to go. We're still tied at 50. Well, Burke has led most of this game, 14-9 at the end of the first quarter, 29-27 at halftime, 42-38 at the end of three. But then Papillion caught them, went in the lead, only to have it tied up. And now, with 16.2 seconds left, do we have OT or not? What shot has Gary Greener come up with? Both of these coaches have been going nose to nose for 5 years. That's how long they've been head coaches. Richie has the basketball. And now the ball is knocked away by Swanson. Swanson runs it down. And now it's knocked out of bounds. And touch last by Burke. Scotty Swanson with another unbelievable play. Boy, I'll tell you, you can't help but like a kid that hustles like that. He knew that Richie didn't have the quickness that he had before he got hurt. He reached around, knocked the ball loose, almost beat the speedier Richie to the ball, tried to knock it to his own teammate. It went out of bounds, and they say Burke touched it last. And then quickly, Papillion-LaVista calls timeout with 8 seconds left to go. We're still tied at 50. And a true miracle finish in the Elgin Hyannis game when, for the second day in a row, Chad Schmidt hit a three-pointer in the final seconds to beat the other team by 1 point. All Papillion-LaVista needs is 1 point to win, but I have a feeling they're not going to get fouled. 8 seconds left. Willie Solomon will play it in. And, of course, you have to watch for the steal. They get it into Teixeira. Out it comes to Ruff. Down to 5 seconds. Open in the corner. Solomon's shot won't go. 2 seconds left. 1 second. There's a shot at the buzzer. Oh, my gosh. It's in and out and no good. Oh, heartstopper time for Papillion-LaVista. That shot would have been good. In and out and back out. Oh, we've got OT. And the Papillion-LaVista fans are taking a heart check right now. Wow! You just thought the game was over when Papillion-LaVista missed the shot, but it almost wasn't. We've got overtime in Class A. It's 50-50 between Omaha Burke and Papillion-LaVista. Two great games in a row. That one almost ended with a miracle shot, as did the game just before it between Hyannis and Elgin. Here we go into OT. It'll be Mungin going up against Ebong. Ebong's a junior. Munchin's a sophomore, so they'll square off again next year. We're tied at 50. 3 minutes of overtime coming up. Now, keep in mind, the thing that is in Papillion's favor is the fact that they will go in the 1-1 if they're fouled. And now, oh no, Kevin Mungin goes down after he tipped the basketball and he's hurt. He twisted and hurt his left ankle, and he's going to be done. Oh, man alive. He timed the jump, so he got it. Kevin Mungin, the 6'5 sophomore who had come in and done such a great job in helping Papio battle back in this game, is down after twisting an ankle. The problem with that, in timing the jump properly, he came down on Ebong's foot. Tied at 50. Ruff. Off it goes to Black. Out it comes to Swanson. Ruff down low. They've got Black. Black goes up. Oh, he just missed a shot. He's fouled. That almost was a three-point play. They worked the backdoor screen. They got Ryan Black wide open underneath, and he got banged but got the shot off. And it hung there and spun out. Black is a 68% free throw shooter. Ryan Black is there for the first time today. It's short. But this would give them the lead. And in overtime, that's all you want is the lead. Make the other team come after you. Second free throw. It's good. Ryan Black with only his third point of the day. 51-50, Papillion-LaVista. with the basketball is Ritchie. Ritchie working on Swanson. Gets it off to Hanson. Inside to Ebong. Ebong goes up and is fouled. Who hooked him? Maybe Ruff. Now let's see if they say he was shooting. He was starting to turn around.
Fouls on John Ruff, his third personal.
Third foul on Ruff. They say he got him. Still, they still have one foul to give away. That's the luxury that Papillion-LaVista's had in this fourth quarter. They get it into Hanson. Hanson back out to Mitchell. Mitchell pulls up 15-footer. In and out, no good. Teixeira with the rebound. Off it goes to Ruff. Still a lot of time left in overtime. 2:25. Papillion-LaVista with a one-point lead. Handling the basketball is Ryan Black. Inside Teixeira. Teixeira missed the point-blank bank shot. Oh, great entry pass from Black, and Teixeira missed it. Hanson on the other end to Ritchie. That would have given him a three-point lead and really let him wheel and deal a little bit. Inside to Ebong. Ebong over to Sheriff's, got it down.
Van
Ebong puts Burke out in front, 52-51. So a missed free throw and a missed point-blank bank shot has got Papillion in the hole. Now, there's an entry pass to Teixeira, and he's fouled by Ritchie. No secret now what they're trying to do is get it down to Teixeira.
Fouls on Jason Ritchie, his first personal foul.
First foul on Ritchie. Teixeira's a 65% free throw shooter. He's two out of three. He'll get two shots. So he can either tie it or put them ahead, or if he'd miss them both, leave it right where it's at. It's up, and it is no good. So Papillion-LaVista haunted by some poor free throw shooting right now. Here's the second one. It's good. We're tied at 52. Nothing's been decided in the overtime. A minute 35 left to go. Ritchie hobbles across the timeline. Goes down to the right wing. Kicks it back up to Hanson. Inside a pass for Ebong. Deflected away. Knocked loose and run down by Ryan Black. And he wants timeout. That pass to Ebong went off the glass. And then Teixeira deflected it in the corner where Black ran it down. Timeout Papillion-LaVista. 1:22 left to go in OT. We're tied at 52. Kevin Albers will insert another guard in his lineup now to handle the ball. As I would anticipate, they'll try and run it down. With a minute 22 left to go, they have the basketball. Also, they'll have to play it in the backcourt. So Kalaw comes in to help handle the basketball, and Swanson will play it in the backcourt. In it comes to Ruff. Ruff working against Hanson. Ruff. Across the timeline comes John Ruff. Nice handling of the basketball. Off to Kalaw, to Black. They get it to Ruff. A minute 10 left to go. Let's see if they try and run it all the way down. Black lobs it down low. Teixeira. Teixeira goes up and is fouled by Ebong. Nice lob pass to Teixeira. They're trying to front David. And he got hammered. That's the fourth foul on Ebong. 42. Willie Solomon returns
at the free throw line
to the Monarch lineup. Teixeira, who just was at the free throw line, up and good. That breaks the tie. It's 53-52 with 2:02 left to go. Teixeira, after missing his first free throw in overtime, has got it measured now. 54-52.
In for Omaha Burke, number 51.
Papillion-LaVista, who were champs way back in 26-27, but they don't have a modern-day championship. And, of course, Omaha Burke, champions in 77 and 86. 57 seconds left to go in overtime. Of course, it's just a two-point lead. And in the day and age of the three-point shot, we've seen the three-pointer make the difference. Into Ebong. Short jump shot won't go. Gets his own rebound. Battles with his own man and travels. Becker and Ebong came down with it together. And Ebong finally wrestled it away but travels. Hanson comes in for Becker. Break for Papio. Papillion-LaVista trying to hang on to a two-point lead in overtime. Backcourt pressure as Swanson gets it in to Teixeira. Teixeira drops it off for Ruff. John Ruff in the backcourt brings it across the timeline. Penetrates right down the middle. And they almost throw it away. Running it down was Willie Solomon. Now knocked away by Richie on the breakaway. Mitchell drives. Finger roll no good, but he's fouled. Papillion-LaVista couldn't take care of the basketball. It was Alvin Mitchell that knocked that away. And Mitchell on the breakaway. We were blocked out by the fans momentarily. That's the second foul on Teixeira, but it will send Alvin Mitchell to the free throw line. For the first time today, he's a 65% free throw shooter. Boy, he couldn't ask for much more pressure. He's got two shots, and Papio's got a two-point lead. It's up, and it is no good. So now what do you do with 29.2 seconds left to go? Do you go to miss? Here comes Mitchell. It's up and it is no good. Rebound kept alive by Ebong. It's a foul over the back on Ben Ebong. Gary Grainer says, wait a minute. Ebong got in there and got a hand on it, but it looked like he used another player to propel him to the basketball. Ebong is gone. Ben Ebong fouls out. Kalaw comes back in for the Monarchs. Gary Grainer is still livid over there, and so is Ebong. Now, this game still is not over. What will make a big difference here is if Papillion-LaVista makes both free throws to give them a four-point lead. Then it would take two possessions. 27.7 left to go in OT. Papillion-LaVista by two. Now we got a big conference going here. Coming in is Kalaw, and out goes Black. At the line will be Willie Solomon. Solomon has made both of his free throws. This game is a long way from being over. What will make the big difference here if Solomon makes them both? Burke calls timeout. Still a ton of time left. 27.7 seconds remaining in overtime. Papillion-LaVista 54, Burke 52. Here we go. Willie Solomon has come through every time he's been asked to in this second half. Now his biggest test. He heads to the free throw line for the second time today. It's up. It is no good. Rebound, Jared Becker. Here comes Hanson. Hanson down to the corner. Pulls up. Gets it out to Richie. Richie back to Hanson. Out of the corner. It's no good. They battle for the rebound. It's knocked out of bounds. Touch last by Papillion-LaVista. Now 34, Black will return, and Kalaw will go out. Still 15.2 seconds left to go. And now Burke wants timeout. Oh! Neither team able to put the other one away. Timeout. 15.2 seconds left in OT. It's Papillion-LaVista 54, Omaha Burke 52. Well, Burke has got all their three-point shooters in there right now. I don't know why. If I were Kevin Albers right now, I'm sure Kevin's stomach is turning too. He's wiping his brow. Lauritsen will inbounds. Lauritsen looking. He better hurry. He called timeout. Oh, that was close. He couldn't inbounds it after the great pressure by Papio. And so it's still Papillion-LaVista 54, Burke 52, timeout. Well, timeouts get to be a big factor here. Burke's got one left, Papillion-LaVista two, in case Burke would have to use another one here on the timeout play. Here's Lauritsen. Lauritsen gets it into Hanson. Down to 13 seconds. Oh, he traveled. He did. He took an extra step. Hanson stopped and took an extra step. And now we're going to get Kalaw back in there. Chad Kalaw is in, and out goes Black. 11.5 seconds left to go. Ruff to play it in. Ruff gets it into Kalaw. Kalaw is fouled in the backcourt with 9.8 seconds left to go. So now the pressure falls on the shoulders of 5'11 junior Chad Kalaw. He has not been to the free throw line. And again, they can put this game away if they can make both of these free throws. Willie Solomon was there moments ago. At least if they make one, the worst they could do was another overtime. Kalaw, who's hit two big buckets. Chad Kalaw. It's up and good! Now, this one would pretty much seal it. This one would pretty much seal it. Kalaw. Now all the Papillion-LaVista players drop off the line. Second free throw. Good! That should do it! There's the ball. 9 seconds left. The shot is up by Richie. It's no good. Long rebound, and we've got a foul. With 4 seconds left to go, we've got a foul on Lauritsen. My old friend Kevin Albers is about to claim his first state championship. Don't tell me good things don't happen to good people. I've tried to stay as impartial as I could throughout this, but I've known Kevin for 17, 18 years now, and it's nothing against Gary Grainer. Gary's a fine person too. But as I say, they have won a championship since 26, 27, and I just want to go on record right now that good things do happen to good people, and Kevin Albers is one of the best. With 4 seconds left to go, it's Papio 56 and Burke 52. Kevin Albers is about to do in this arena what he couldn't do 16 years ago in 1977. He and the Lincoln High Lynx were here. They didn't win the state championship. He didn't win the state championship as a player, but he's about to win it as a coach. 4-point lead with 4 seconds left to go, and John Ruff will be at the line. And with a 4-point lead, it is just impossible. Free throw is up and good. Papio is about to win their first modern-day state tournament, and Kevin Albers and his coaching staff put their jackets on. They're ready to celebrate. It's good. And near steal on the inbounds pass. Richie gets it, and that's it. That's going to do it. Final score in OT. Papillion-LaVista, 58. Burke, 52 in overtime. What a game it was. It shows you what patience and tenacity will do. As Papillion-LaVista battled back and battled back and battled back, and finally persistence paid off in overtime. The 1993 Class A state champions, the Monarchs of Papillion-LaVista, 58, Omaha Burke, 52.
Adam Jokes. Number 40.